Magandang gabi sa bayan ng Pilipino, Rion 12 at lalawigan ng South Cotabato. Welcome sa Panayam sa Pangulo. At ito po ngayong gabi ay makasama rin natin ngayon ang one of the most influential leaders in the world, the Philippine President, Pangulong Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo. Madam, magandang gabi po.
Mayang gabi, Chris.
Okay. Madam, gusto natin talakayin itong mga development para sa kaunlaran ng ating bansa, lalong-lalo dito sa Rion 12. Isa po sa mga katanungan ng ating mga mamayan dito, itong Sok Sargon Region ay na-notice na mas lalong umimprove yung kanilang tourist destination. Maraming pumupunta dito at gusto nilang may saayos kung may plano po ang Arroyo Administration na palawakin o ayusin itong ating General Santos City Airport o improve po, Madam President.
Oo, good. Kasi importante infrastructure sa atong economic reform program. So, siyempre, kaupod diri ang enhancement sa General Santos Airport, ang terminal building, yes, ang perimeter fencing. So, may ara akitang 30 million peso project for the terminal and the fencing that will be undergoing bidding na subong, okay, and it will be awarded within the next 30 days.
Uh-huh. Okay, thank you, Madam President.
At, so that will really support efforts to make Sok Sargon a major destination.
Yes, thank you very much, Madam President, for that. No. Anyway, Madam President, ang Pangulong Gloria Scholarship, no?
Oo.
Dito sa Rion
12. Oh, mga scholars naton, mayang gabi.
Oo, ay bukang bibig na po at maraming natutulungan. At angkop sa panahon ito, Madam President, itong Pangulong Gloria Scholarship na maraming nakaabil. Ano po ba, Madam President, para maintindihan ng ating mga tagapakinig at hindi pa nila alam sa ibang mga kanayunan, kung paano ba i-avail itong Pangulong Gloria Scholarship po natin.
Okay, first of all, I'm glad to hear no na itong scholarship program nakakaabot sa mga those who need it and making an impact. Impact is one of our many measures to help mitigate the impact sining global crisis. So, sa training, kag-retraining sa ato mga kabataan, kag sa ato mga unemployed, sa mga bagong technical skills, makahatag sang oportunidad to find new jobs, or even to start their own businesses. Para makaabot ang mas madamo, linakihan natin ang budget. Before my administration, 200 million pesos ang budget sa skills training. Subong, 3 billion ang budget sa skills training. That's why you can feel the difference. And we're making the requirements simpler. So if you're 15 years old and above, kung ikaw Filipino citizen, kung ikaw ang imong gusto to learn a skill that will be able to help you find a job or start a business, then you can qualify. So ang importante diri mag-apply sa nearest test the office. And there is a test the office here in Coronadal, and there's a test the office also in General Santos City.
Sa Cotabato, sa Wool.
Okay,
so thank you very much, Madam President, sa explanation mo, no, upang makabil yung iba pa natin mga kawayan at mga out of school youth natin. May mga ginagawa pa ang Arroyo Administration na solusyonan yung iba pa natin problema. Bukod sa global crisis ngayon, Madam President.
Well, we're doing everything to support our workers during these challenging times. Mm-hmm. And these efforts range from investments that will create new jobs. Uh-huh. Like the one kanina, yung sa Pangasio, sa investment ng RDEX. Uh-huh. No? At saka, livelihood assistance to affected workers. Mm-hmm. Meron pa rin yung retraining program nga na binanggit natin. Kaupod sa atong sabat sa displacement sa mga trabaho, ang comprehensive livelihood employment emergency employment program or CLIP. So, sining programa isang umbrella program, mga line agency. And here sa Region 12, CLIP has helped already 8,500 individuals. And we are thankful to the Petroleum Association of the Philippines for partnering with the government. Kay 14% sa sining 8,500 are beneficiaries of the component from the Petroleum Association. Mm-hmm. So these initiatives are helping to create new jobs for those affected by the downturn. And so kung may ara pa mga nawala sa trabaho, halin sa global economic crisis, makadtog ka mo sa pinakamalapit nga Dole office, Dole mm-hmm. office, to inquire about the programs that can assist you.
Uh-huh. Okay, that's it. Thank you, Madam President. Now, napag-usapan natin yung hinggil po sa development, edukasyon. Punta naman tayo po sa Pisinodo situation.
Yes,
no?
Yes.
May problema tayo dito sa Rion 12 about insurgency problem, uh-huh. Madam President. At gusto natin malaman kung pa kung kailan ba mag-full grown yung ating peace talks.
Oo, okay, kung gusto nato nga may ara long-term peace and prosperity in Mindanao, ginakinahanglan na magbalik kita sa peace process. So we're awaiting advice from our facilitator, the Government of Malaysia, as to when, where, what time magsugod sa liwat ang atong peace process. I had a chance to talk to the new Prime Minister of Malaysia, Tun Razak, twice during the last 30 days. And he gave us the assurance that they will support the peace process, that they will persevere. They will persevere in ensuring that the peace talks will resume. Mm-hmm. So in the meantime, Ambassador Rafael Segues, who is here with us today, he is our chairman of the peace panel, is back channeling with the MILF with regard to the yung agenda of the peace talks and the talking points between the peace panel. The panel is being assisted by the advisor on the peace process, which is Secretary Avelino Cruz, former chief PNP. And he's helping in other aspects of the peace process because ang peace process, hindi lang ang negotiation. Ang peace process, damo ang mga aspeto. So Secretary Avelino Razon is helping there. Kay gusto naton nga magbalik sa liwat ang magrain ang reign of peace diri sa Mindanao. Apan kay kinakinahanglan na ma-patient kita, no? We have to be patient as we undergo the peace process kasi hindi nato ma-resolvar kining dugay na anay par nga problema with quick fix solutions.
Yes, okay. So, yun pong update natin sa peace in order to sa Mindanao, Madam President. No? So, punta to sa localized, Madam President. Uh-oh. As I remember, it's a part of your 10-point agenda, the South Southern Region. And one of these is
Mga
regional
new,
center natin.
New
yes.
government centers. Yes,
Madam
yes.
President. So, ano pong update natin ito, Madam President, sakaling hindi na matupad yung deadline as you have directed na magkaroon ng deadline.